Hello friends, have you noticed? All rainbows are curved and circular. Why? Today, we will have a detailed explanation on this, and before going to that, let's have a quick look at the process of rainbow formation. So we have a humid day and lot of water droplets are suspended in the atmosphere. And here comes the light from the sun. As the white light enters the raindrop, dispersion or splitting of white light into colors happens at the front face. The dispersed light is reflected at the back face, and that reflected light is bent or refracted at the front face and leaves the droplet at a diverging angle. If I stand in the path of violet ray, I would see this raindrop as violet. Similarly, I would see different raindrops in different colors like this, and rainbow is formed for me. In this whole process of rainbow formation, what is the water drop doing to light? It receives the white light, splits it into colors, and sends out most intense violet light at an angle of 40 degrees and most intense red light at an angle of 42 degrees. For a very detailed and simple explanation about splitting of white light into colors, refraction, and other conditions for formation of rainbow, please watch our exclusive video on that. The link is given in the description. Now, let's move on to answer the bigger question, why rainbow is curved. Let's say I am standing on the top of this hill and I have sun in the back of my head and an array of suspended water droplets in front of me as seen here. All these water drops would receive sunlight, split it into colors and send out violet light in 40 degree and red light in 42 degree. If we see a single raindrop, when white light is received here, it is deflecting most intense violet light into 40 degree into its bottom, and when it receives white light at this location, it deflects 40 degree into top, and when the light is received here, it is deflected like this, and thus light is deflected to all possible directions or into a cone with cone angle 40 degree. But whether this drop forms a color for me depends on my location. If this cone passes through my eyes, I would see this raindrop as violet. For example, cone from this raindrop passes through my eyes, so I would see this drop as violet. Whereas, the deflected violet light from this drop does not pass through my eyes and I will not see this particular raindrop as colored. Now, to find out the shape of violet band of rainbow, I just need to find the shape made by all the drops which appear violet to me. For that, let's try to find out which all raindrops out of these would be violet for me. The only condition is that the light after being turned into 40 degree by the drop should pass through my eyes, and sun's rays can be treated as parallel for this assessment since sun is too far from me. If we see path of this violet ray which reaches the observer's eyes, and if I construct an angle like this with a line parallel to sun's rays, we can see that this angle is also 40 degree. Or, in other words, for all the violet rays which reach the observer, this angle also would be 40 degree. And now we can see that if we make a cone with the observer at the apex and cone angle as 40 degree, all the drops lying on this cone would be violet for the observer. And when viewed by the observer, the drops lying on this cone at a particular direction will appear one behind the other, and the overall shape of this cone appears as a circle to the person standing on the apex. So, the shape of the violet band will be circular. And for red, the only difference would be that the angle would be 42 degree instead of 40 degree. And similarly, the band of other colors also will be circular, and the cone angle would range from 40 degree for violet to 42 degree for red. And yes, all rainbows are in fact circular. But to see this fully circular rainbow, the observer should be at a higher elevation like this, and suspended drops should be present in the full circular area. Often when we observe rainbow from the ground, we see only a part of the circle and it appears curved or in arc shape to us. The remaining part of the full circle may be below ground, or suspended water droplets may not be spread out to cover the entire area to make up a full circle. And we can see that rainbows are different for different observers based on their respective locations, or rainbows are not something that is physically available there, or they are just optical illusions visible to only a particular observer based on his location. So, next time when you phone your friend who is at a different location to show a rainbow which you are seeing, be aware that he may not be able to see that. That's it for today. Subscribe, click the bell button, support us, signing off. Science for Common Man.